Buried inside the red planet, a long-sought discovery adds to the speculation there may have once been life on Mars.
Well, the final remarks are very simple. Water is there. We have nothing more, any doubt.
Unveiling their findings at a news conference, scientists at the Italian Space Agency announced that they have located an underground lake on Mars, the first stable body of liquid ever found on the red planet. After years studying data from a ground-penetrating radar on an orbiting spacecraft, the Italian researchers say they have identified a large liquid reservoir buried over a kilometer beneath an ice sheet near the South Pole. It's a discovery that raises a tantalizing possibility.
There are all the ingredients for thinking that life can be there or can be maintained there if life once existed on Mars, Martian surface.
Comparing it to a subglacial lake on Earth, researchers said the Martian reservoir may resemble a habitat, although there's no evidence to support that yet. But a body of water on Mars not only has implications for finding life or proving it was once there, but also for our future exploration on the red planet.
Finding water on Mars is very important for practical reasons for human exploration, because you don't have to bring the water with you. You need the water to survive for long periods of time on Mars, but you also can make fuel out of it. And so having it accessible on the planet itself is almost enabling for human exploration on Mars.
Outside experts have not yet been able to confirm the Italian Space Agency's findings, but evidence that Mars was once a wet planet has been observed several times. A huge underground lake could help us understand how billions of years changed our neighboring planet and what that could mean for our future here on Earth.
Well, let's speak to planetary scientist Roberto Orese, who is the principal investigator behind this finding. Roberto, an incredible discovery. Wow. How did you find this evidence of a liquid lake beneath the surface of Mars?
The radar could detect very strong echoes from the bottom of the ice sheet. And this, on Earth, is almost invariably associated with the presence of liquid water. By working by analogy, we could try to draw this conclusion, but because the conditions of Mars are so exotic and it was complex to prove it through, we had to undergo through 2 years of gruesome analysis, simulations, and reanalysis to convince ourselves and eventually the reviewers of the paper that that was the only possible explanation, or at least the most likely by far.
Now, it's an incredible finding. You know, we know that it's very cold on Mars, and yet this was a liquid lake that was discovered, no doubt because of the salts, the chemical components that are inside this body of water. Does this mean that this lake can support life on Mars?
On Earth, we have bacteria, microorganisms that are capable of surviving in very cold waters, and also that can use even salts for their own metabolism. So even if we do not really know enough about this subglacial water to draw a firm conclusion, it's possible that existing life on Earth could survive in such an environment. So it's habitable, potentially habitable.
That's interesting. You're saying that this subsurface lake could help eventually support human settlements on Mars, but then again, this is under the surface of Mars. What would it take to actually drill through and to access this body of water?
Well, it will certainly take a lot of energy, new technology, determination, and international consensus that this is worth doing it. And I think this last will come over the next years, if we continue exploring Mars and we find other evidence of liquid water there or elsewhere. If we were to find that liquid water is common on Mars, that would certainly raise the stakes for going there and look for the content of this water, the composition of this water, let's say, hoping to find some trace of Martian life.
Wow, and there could be other liquid lakes yet to be discovered, located underneath the Martian surface. Roberto, we're going to have to leave it at that, but many congratulations to you and your team for this incredible discovery.